because the pink print is her. How pretty is Nicki Minaj?
She's perfection.
Hi, hi Nicki Minaj. Hi, hi baby. Hi. How are you? You look so hello. Good. Wow. I mean, I couldn't have said that when we worked together because it would have been awkward, but wow. Smoking.
Let me stop this music. I'm sorry.
That's okay. How are you?
I'm well.
You're better than well. The album came out. People are so into it. Mm-hmm. Like they're responding to it in a big way. I got you some pink helium balloons. You can
oh
suck
my
them later.
God. Did you get these for me?
Yeah.
Yeah, those are for
thank
you.
You.
You know what's fun? You can suck all of them later. It's good for your head.
All the helium.
You know, the helium voice?
That's really good for a singer, isn't it?
You know. It's good. They're fun.
Okay, I'll think
about that. All right. Hey, so this is happy birthday.
Yeah, my birthday was on the 8th.
What'd
so
you
thank
do?
You.
What'd you do?
I was in New York, yeah. So that was a blessing because I got to see my family and my really close friends.
Yeah.
And I just had like an intimate dinner.
Yeah.
And
who sat next to your right?
Your mama?
A new boy.
Shut up! no new boy at that dinner.
Mm. At that dinner? What about the after party? So is it close
is
friends?
This thing on?
It was close friends, right? Just like an intimate close friends.
Yeah, my close friends. My mommy.
She's so proud.
My brothers, yeah. Mm-hmm. And she always gets me like the most, the like the weirdest gift. What? Like a picture frame. And I'm just like, here. Oh, gee, thanks.
Yeah, here's a picture frame so you can put pictures of you in your home. You know
right.
what I mean?
Yes.
My mom does that too, but she gives it to me with the picture of the family.
The picture in it.
It's the family, not me. Mm-hmm. It's well, the it's the posed the picture. No, it's the picture of the model family.
Oh.
Yeah. So I still I put them up just like that. All right, so Pink Print. The Pink Print is this album. When you think about the album as a whole, what does it embody for you? Like, what does it cover for you?
To me, you know, it's interesting because with both of my other albums, I always record them in 3 months. And the Pink Print took me a year to record.
Right.
And it was really frustrating because I wanted to put it out since the summertime. But now looking back, I understand why I needed to take that time. Just as a woman, I was going through so many changes in my life professionally and personally. And it was good for me to just take a month, come back, right? Reflect, take a month, come back, write, reflect. And now what the Pink Print represents to me is a brand new chapter, like something that I kind of have put a lid on. It's, you know, there's a lot of pain and emotions on it. But there's also, I feel like it also is very triumphant, too, in a way, because I got to get it out. Like 2 years went by and people could only hear me rapping about like stuff that really doesn't matter in life, because I do features and it's always like a fun verse.
Right.
But when you write your album, you get to talk about your family and love and all of that stuff.
Did you discover stuff about you?
Well, I definitely discovered that I wasn't as afraid as I thought I was. I used to feel like I was so afraid to share personal things.
Yeah.
And I realized when I write them and I put them to a beat, it makes it a little bit easier for me to share it, to talk about it.
That's
yeah,
important.
To talk about it.
Ryan, maybe you should try that.
Try what?
Writing songs.
You know, I can't write. No, I'm not that vulnerable. You know, but I mean, I would definitely be a guest. But she's got Lil Wayne and Beyonce and Drake. She didn't need me.
Well,
I don't mean with her, you
but
know.
But you, I mean, you don't need, you could, I'd be happy to be needed by you.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So tell me about your relationship with Beyonce, because she's on a track here.
You know, it's everybody asks me that.
Well, then I shouldn't ask.
No, it's a dope relationship. I mean, obviously, I look up to her, and I was so shocked to find out that she was like a fan of my work.
Right.
And so she reached out months ago for me to get on the remix to Flawless, and she said, you know, I'll do something for your album as well. And I didn't believe it until I saw it. So I never told anybody about it. Like, I just kept it a big secret. And then she sent me Feeling Myself. She said, you know, there's a record that I think we might, you know, sound good together on. And I heard it, and I took a while. But finally, I got it to a place where I felt like I loved it. And then she took it back and did some changes. And I think it's just a real woman power type relationship.
Right.
You know, where every time I speak to her, I learn something.
But But I mean, a pretty incredible and amazing feeling to have someone like that go, oh, you know what? I really respect, like, and like want to do stuff with you. I mean, that's cool.
Incredible. Right? Incredible. Incredible.
Okay. Nicki Minaj is here. Oh, it's been so long since I've seen you.
You guys used to see each other a lot.
I know.
We used to hang quite a bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But no longer.
No.
Did you drive a pink car here?
No, I did not.
You have one.
Not anymore.
Oh, not anymore. She's done for the pink
car. Pink car's gone. Okay. Yeah. The pink print is available on iTunes. We're going to come back with Nicki Minaj here. Okay. Here
maybe
we go.
The
ready?
Next one.
I don't want to hurt you.
Oh. Did you feel that?
I used the backboard. Okay, you're done. You can take it off.
Did you say you used the backboard?
Yeah.
Do you want to keep this?
What's the next question?